At its best, travel broadens your horizons. At its worst, travel changes you into an unrecognizable monster who will kill for a foil bag containing 6 mini pretzels.
One of the reasons why we feel uncomfortable when we travel is because we're used to a specific set of rules that guide our interactions with one another.
Economist Dr. Charity Joy Acciardo says travel can skew those unwritten rules of human behavior.
When those rules change, we don't necessarily know the information that's being passed back and forth.
So we're sorting out the economics of travel behavior. Let's start with every airport's monument to man's inhumanity to man, the luggage carousel. Everyone rushes to where the luggage comes out.
That doesn't leave room for anyone else, so they have to take the spot next to you and then the spot next to that person until you're all the way around the carousel.
Economists have a name for this kind of situation.
That's called a tragedy of the commons.
Nobody owns space at the carousel, so it's a free-for-all for position.
Everybody does what's best for them without thinking what's best for the group.
Economics suggests a better strategy.
So what really makes sense efficiency-wise is to stand back a few feet, and when your piece of luggage comes in, move up to the front, take it away quickly, and allow room for somebody else to come in and get their luggage.
Next, they're still around, so let's talk taxis, which have a crucial problem. You and the driver have misaligned incentives, because while you want a fast, cheap ride,
they have an incentive to keep you in that cab for as long as possible, because while that meter's running, they're making money. And this problem has a name. It's called moral hazard.
Uber addresses moral hazard by agreeing to the price ahead of time. At a conference, a taxi ride cost Charity Joy 30 minutes and a lot of money. The same ride in an Uber?
The driver took me the back routes. It took 5 minutes to get to my hotel.
Because the incentives between her and the driver were in alignment. Finally, let's look at a quirk of Airbnb. Most people search by ratings.
They say, oh, this has 500 five-star ratings. It has to be a good place.
When Charity Joy stayed at a five-star dump, she took a closer look.
What I saw was they didn't have reviews all the time. So they were constantly booked, but the reviews came in once every few months or so.
Airbnb guests and hosts can decline to book in either direction. And because a five-star rating is so crucial, hosts have an incentive.
Hey, when we look at people that might be renting our place, we don't look at what other hosts have said about them. What we look at is what they have said about other hosts, because that's what's going to matter to me and my Airbnb.
Economists call this game theory.
And this is actually a very classic prisoner's dilemma.
Meaning individuals have incentives to make choices that might hurt the group.
An Airbnb host's dominant strategy is to rent to people who write good reviews.
So that's a key disparity to check.
Hey, this person hasn't had a lot of reviews, even though they have a lot of bookings. That's a red flag for me.
Economic insights to travel are at the top of the list.